What do Maria the First of Portugal, King Charles the Sixth of France, and Caligula of Rome all have in common? Besides being, you know, rulers. They were all pretty much crazy. King Charles VI, for example, thought that he was made of glass. Caligula of Rome once commanded his guards to throw a large section of the arena spectators into the lion's pit because he got bored. And Maria I, in later life, kinda thought she was being chased by devils. But what are the origins of the word crazy? Crazy's etymological roots seem somewhat unclear, but a likely origin comes from the old French word écrasé, itself a borrowing from Old Norse. Écrasé, whose modern form écrasé, like the older form, means to break, shatter, crush, or crack, made its way into Middle English as a craze. Then, through a process called aphoresis, the word lost its initial A. Aphoresis simply refers to the loss of one or more sounds at the beginning of a word, especially in the case of unstressed vowels. Given the fact that the craze part of the word a craze forms the stressed syllable, the unstressed syllable A dropped off in casual speech. A craze became craze. To understand how this could happen, try saying the following several times quickly. I'm gonna a-craze you. I'm gonna craze you. I'm gonna craze you. I'm gonna craze you. I'm gonna craze you. See what I mean? But the A-less version of the word was a verb, and it wasn't until around the end of the 16th century that we begin to see the word crop up as a noun as well. And this new noun form, pronounced the same as the verb, referred to a breach, crack, or flaw. Around that same time, craze started to be used as an adjective as well, with the addition of the derivational suffix y, which added the meaning of having the qualities of. And thus, having the qualities of a breach or crack or full of cracks was the original meaning of the modern English word crazy, which was used to describe objects such as buildings or ships that were cracked, broken down, shaky, or unsound. Shortly thereafter, we started to use the word to describe people who were of an unsound or cracked mind. In other words, insane people. So although we don't often think about the origins of the word crazy, it actually has a lot in common with another idiom for an insane person, cracked. As in the phrase, I think he's finally cracked. Ah! So that's how crazy took its place to become one of the most common words for an insane person, surpassing even more modern words such as nuts and bananas. But crazy hasn't stopped there, as it has taken on even more meanings throughout the years. I can be crazy for a girl like one-hit wonders Evan and Jaren, which means I'm immoderately infatuated with her. I can be crazy about Star Wars, suggesting that I'm obsessed with it, though still quite sane. So, who's your favorite Jedi? I prefer the more obscure Jedi, like Barak-Kl. And I can say, that was a crazy dream. Which could suggest that my dream had elements of insanity, but most likely means that I had a bizarre or strange dream. And it can be used in even more situations, like in crazy bread, which I just think means surprisingly delicious bread. Until next time, I'm gonna go back in time and watch King Charles think he's glass. Did that sound too crazy?